Can we find where we've got first though? Okay.
Thank you. That's actually Joe, chucking a break.
Hey, yeah.
Yeah. You could cut quick extra grand.
What's up?
Casper and Catherine are up for four.
Hi, Mona! Go,
kid off!
Well done, Jazz.
Thank you.
Go back on four. The basics. Nice.
Go, Jordy.
Barwon!
Barwon!
No, me either. They actually have to have no man on the
bar.
You'd be like, you had the distance, you just kicked 10 metres. You run in another 5 metres.
Good job, Vaughn!
Come on! Charlie! Good job, Vaughn!
Yeah, no, that would be
up there. Come on! Come on!
Yeah. Leave it 10 minutes.
Start second, mate.
Oh, yeah.
Shut up.
Oh, yeah.
Thomas, what have you done? And Mum's like, nah, do it, it's funny. Yeah, where is Thomas?
She missed when he said ask where I was playing, and I was like, oh,
this is
doing
stuff.
Push up!
Yeah. Come on, girls, just be a warrior. Stop playing like warriors, they don't. Stop playing like warriors, girls.
Thank you.
that aggressive. But that's good because you can get mad. My mom would punch you back. Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Y If the Grain Boys don't cover like a half, what's the point? Is it the Grain Boys don't cover like a half?
She covers like a half.
Thank you.
just got yourself in the coach outside the corner.
Thank you. Thank you. Come on! Thank you. Let's go, work, guys! Test. Thank you, Cam. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Epworth AFL Barwon Female Football Senior Division 3 Grand Final presentation. To see so many of you in front of us today is an absolute testament to the teams in front of us, the spirit in which you play today. And I think we can all say with a collective round of applause, congratulations to both teams in front of us. North Geelong, you set the standard this season. You played extremely well. And for yourselves representing your club, you should be extremely proud of what you have achieved this year and what you are doing for female football within your club. There are so many proud people here today that will be very proud of your performance, win or loss. And we hope that you can continue to build as a club into next year. To Modda, for yourselves, first year as a club with female football, and to have so many spectators here supporting yourselves, I think it's testament to the way you've played this year, and also to get a premiership in your first year is an incredible achievement. To yourselves and to so many of your club representatives here today, congratulations. For us at AFL Barwon, these competitions and the days like this would not be possible if it wasn't for a phenomenal amount of support from so many people. Firstly, to St. Joseph's and the incredible work that they've done second year in a row to put on female football grand finals is exceptional. For today's presentation, I'm very fortunate to be joined firstly by AFL Barwon Commissioner Dave Milson and also from Epworth, our major partner for female football within the AFL Barwon region, Nikki Longian as well. So please come up to the stage. We know games are not possible without umpires, but I think we can all collectively say that the way that our umpires officiated today was brilliant, and we're very proud of the way that they represent our region and support all of our competitions week in, week out. So we'd love to take this opportunity firstly to say thank you to all our umpires today. I'd now like to call to the stage firstly our goal umpires, Gwenda and Lucy, for your medals. To our boundary umpires of Charlotte, Ella and Ruby. And to our field umpires of Peter, Jay and Blake. Like our umpires, it takes so many people, it takes an army to be able to put these competitions on. And further to that, for so many of you who are here today, who've created signs, who've supported the young ladies in front of us, whether you're a parent, you're a family member, a brother, sister, a member of a club, thank you for the role that you are doing within our community to boost and lift female football and provide these ladies with the opportunities week in, week out. So thank you from AFL Barwon. For today, best on ground has come from Modda, number 26, Monique Martin. I'd now like to call to the stage the North Geelong coach to say a few words.
First of all, thanks to all the supporters to come out and support both teams. Been a really good day. Modewarre, fantastic. You know, from the practice match we had at the start of the season, it's been really, really fun to play against you all year, so well done, you're well deserved. And the North girls, yeah, bad luck, but next year we'll come back stronger. All right, good work.
I'd now like to call to the stage from Modewarre, their coach, Nick Allison. Mark
actually organise. Firstly, I'd just like to acknowledge the traditional custodians of the land of what we played on today, the Wathaurong people of the Kulin Nation. To AFL Barwon, Ed, and especially Raish Kirtley, in our side, the work that you do, I see firsthand. It's a peril of work, and a lot of it goes unrewarded. So thank you. It wouldn't be possible if it wasn't for the work you do. To obviously the league sponsor Epworth, thank you for always giving back to female football. As long as I've been a part of it, you've always been there and continue to be, so it's fantastic. Thank you. To North Geelong, to Matt Coombe and you girls, you're in a very similar boat to us at the start of the year. We're just having a chat with numbers, but when you have good culture, people come, and we're very similar clubs. You can tell there's a lot of respect between us, and because you're good people, and when you're good people, things grow. So keep doing what you're doing, you're going in the right direction. To the Modewarre family support crew, we say we're the best country club, we say we're a community, and you can tell there's so many people, past players, netballers, everyone that's come down today to support. What we do isn't possible without what they do, so thank you to them. To our jumper sponsors as well, Grilled, and especially the Pink Angels Geelong, Janet, Jamie and the Boddington family, you've jumped on straight away, you've helped us so much. We love being the Pink Angels, and we'll carry that on for years to come. Thank you. To our committee for giving us the opportunity to do this. I know it was at a Mad Monday celebration last year that I said I wanted to do this, and straight away we put our heads together and we've created a great community within the girls club. We're welcomed, and thank you to Shaga, Fitzy and everybody else that has jumped on board to help us. And lastly, to our girls, at the start of the year when we played in a practice match, girls didn't know which way to stand, any of the rules. Charlie still doesn't know the rules, but that's all right. So, but you just kept learning, kept trying, kept getting better, and now we've built this beautiful group that I'm sure will play North Geelong next year in many finals to come. So thank you. Number two, Clem Thompson. Number four, Nat Amalfi. Number five, Chloe Prout. Number seven, Lou Cale. Number eight, Tori Hogan. Number nine, Georgie Thompson. Number 10, Georgia Kersop Cole. Number 13, Maddie Quillam. Number 14, Ebony Lilico. Number 15, Sophie McCartney. Number 16, Rachel Kirtley. Number 17, Kat Biskin. Number 21, Lily Bowers. Number number 22, Sophie Allison. Number 24, Charlie Arbuckle. Number 25, Tara Coleman. Number 26, best on ground, Mon Martin. Number 27, Kayla Schenschlog. Number 29, Jess Brewer. Yeah. Number 31, Tamika Brown. Yeah. Number 32, Ash Feehan. Yeah. Number 37, Kalani Boddington. And our captain, number 1, Clodagh Newton.
I'd now like to invite both coach and captain back to the stage to receive the Premiership Cup.